Hello and welcome to another episode of Virtual Legality. I'm your host, Richard Hoeg, managing member of the Hoeg Law Business Law Firm of Northville, Michigan. And today, the day after Election Day, I know from some of your comments and from some of you commenting at me or to me or just disparaging me, whatever it might be that you find me on in social media, I know you want me to talk about the election and some various results that are happening, the Pennsylvania problem and other things that we have discussed in this space. But frankly, there's still a long way to go with whatever is going to happen in the election, everything that's going to happen with litigation, everything that's going to happen with those court cases. There will be plenty of time to discuss the ramification of those later. And after all, here in Virtual Legality, we aren't actually a politics channel. We aren't actually talking about those kinds of things all too often. But if something happens, I assure you, I will. With that as the first disclaimer of this video, I want to talk to you about video games. It is next generation launch next week. PlayStation 5 is launching. Xbox Series X and Series S, which will be a subject of this video in particular, will be launching. People should be excited. Regardless of what happens on the political stage, the world stage, whatever it might be, there are fun things that are happening. There are fun products that are coming out. And if you're anything like me, you're excited about finally getting your hands on them. Along with those launches are the launches of some pretty big video games. November is traditionally a pretty big month for the launch of video game products, and this November is no exception. On your screen right now is a blog post from Activision and Call of Duty talking about their newest game, the newest in the Black Ops series, Black Ops Cold War. And we're going to talk about the ramifications of this particular blog post as it pertains to that next generation launch. But first, we're going to talk about why I even came to this topic. This is a hat tip to Dom at Dom's Playing over on Twitter. He says, Call of Duty Black Ops Cold War will take up more than a third of the available hard drive space on Xbox Series S at launch. And he puts up the gigabytes that the Activision blog post has put up with respect to this launch. And I wanted to give him the hat tip because I wouldn't have actually started looking at this right now if it hadn't been for him. Now, the second disclaimer of this video is as follows. If you have listened to Thabto, Two Hoegs Are Better Than One, and you've heard me talk with my brother, who's a game developer out in California, you know he is working on Call of Duty. He has worked on this project. Now, he doesn't know the subject matter of this video. I haven't talked with him about it, but I have to give that disclaimer. I feel like I should because, hey, I have a familial interest in the success of the product. I want to see his stuff succeed. He's excited about it finally coming out. And so you should know that going in. But I do have a problem with Activision. I do have a problem with this approach that they have taken to the Call of Duty enterprise in and of itself. And I really do have this cautionary tale kind of heartburn about next generation in general and the hard drive sizes that they have gone out with, particularly because they were trying to achieve this quick load state functionality on consoles, which meant that they really had to go with solid state drives, which are expensive, and those solid state drives are smaller, but the actual games didn't change their size. Now, first we see in this blog post, file size at launch, apostrophe, and I love it. At launch, right? You look at that and you say, well, you've already got these enormous file sizes. You actually have to disclaim. Somebody in legal said, hey, we should note that this is just what you have to allocate on your hard drive when we actually launch the game, and that can change. And of course, that has been the experience that people have had with Call of Duty this past cycle. I've pulled up a GameSpot article that now says, Call of Duty Modern Warfare doesn't fit on a single 250 gigabyte solid state drive anymore. Because after some updates, it went up above 200 gigs. And this was the experience that Call of Duty players had, even though when you first bought the game, Modern Warfare was only at about, I think it was about 60 gigabytes here. I pulled up a Digital Trends article, right? So if you go and you look at this, you look at the game as it launched, Call of Duty was 60 gigs, which isn't nothing. A lot of games would see that as a very big size. And it went up hundreds of gigabytes. Now, they've been working on it. Activision has tried to get that number down from 200 and 250 and help you find ways to get it down. But also as part of this discussion, you see 95, 133, 93, 136, was this notion that Microsoft has put out there, that some other people have put out there, that maybe the next generation solid state drives are gonna be okay. Because, hey, because we have these memory bandwidth improvements, we have this other functionality that you're actually going to get in the hardware, maybe Just the fact that Modern Warfare is 200 gigabytes or 250 gigabytes, or Red Dead Redemption 2 is 100 plus gigabytes, those numbers are going to come down because of X, Y, or Z technological reason. Now, that might still happen later on in the generation, but this is really one of the first instances that we have seen with Call of Duty suggesting that that isn't going to happen, at least in the cross-generational period, and at least not until these developers figure out how to shrink these sizes. You can see just the difference between PlayStation 4 at 95 gigabytes and PlayStation 5 at 133. Very similar differences on the Xbox side of things between the One and the Series X and S. Now, one thing I want to say as kind of another disclaimer, just stepping back, is it doesn't make a lot of sense to me that X and S would necessarily have the same size. You're usually getting the size from uncompressed textures and things that are most going to benefit your 4K outputs on something like the Series X, but I don't think anybody has any understanding that the Series S is going to perform in that exact same way for Call of Duty, Black Ops, Cold War. So it wouldn't surprise me if they actually tried to skip a step here and say X and S is the same size, and maybe it's not. Of course, if it's the same application, maybe it is, and you're just getting all these extra textures that your Series S isn't going to use. But in fact, if that is the case, someone might be able to find it, data mine it, figure it out, and Activision would probably take some heat for it. Because as you got from that tweet from Dom at Dom's Playing, the big issue here is for those Series S purchasers, the low-end next-generation hardware on the Xbox side of the equation, they're not getting the same hard drive space, and this is a significant issue. Now, I've also highlighted here in blue something that Activision is trying to do, which I think is absolutely fundamentally necessary, as we'll talk about when we get to the conclusion of this video, but they have stated that they are going to help people get rid of what they aren't using. Note, console players can choose to uninstall specific game mode packs, such as for campaign or zombies, in order to reduce the game's overall file size. This content can be managed in-game through the account and network section of the settings menu, which is great, right? You want to be able to have these kinds of things separated. Call of Duty for a long time has been a kind of melange of different activities. Do I want to play zombies at the same time I want to play multiplayer? Probably not. Certainly not the same time when I want to play campaign. And they've always been kind of roughly attached together with spitballs, bubblegum, and baling wire. And so it makes sense if you are Activision to say, hey, okay, you could start cutting some of these things off, and maybe you'll start to get real significant gains. You can kind of see the sizes of these things on the PC level here below, 35 for multiplayer, 82 for the full game, and 125 for the full game on Ultra Graphics, and start to get a feel for what's happening up here and what savings you might be able to achieve with the removal of certain quote-unquote game mode packs. But you can also see, from the lawyer's perspective, that Activision is making no commitment that these same sizes will apply to anything except that personal computer platform. So now what you've got is a situation where if you are thinking about buying an Xbox Series S next week, you've got Activision and Call of Duty telling you they're going to use 136 gigabytes of your hard drive. And if you go and you look at these things, you see that the PlayStation has 825 gigabytes, the Series X, the higher-end Xbox model, has 1 terabyte, and the Series S has 512 gigabytes. But if this isn't your first rodeo in video gaming or just in general in operating a computer system, you know that these are basically the aspirational sizes for what you might be able to get out of your hard drive, because the operating system and some other bells and whistles and whatever else they're doing with compression is going to take up some amount of space, which is why it was interesting that an Xbox Series S apparently got into the hands of somebody in Canada a week early and has been reporting on it on Reddit. Of course, I will link this particular Reddit thread in the description of this video. You can check all this out. But one thing that he is reporting, and there's no real reason to lie about this, and it makes sense for what we know about how these operating systems work, is that what you will have on Series S is 364 gigabytes for games and apps, which is how you get to Dom saying, oh my gosh, it's going to take up more than a third of the available hard drive space on the Xbox Series S. Now, we're also seeing leaks and reports and rumors that you've got a similar kind of reduction on the PlayStation 5 level, I believe, is the one we've seen. I don't know that we've seen one from X, but we can assume it. You're going to get something like 800 gigs on the X and something like 6 and change on the PlayStation 5, and that's still going to be bad. I've put a picture in this thumbnail of the Series S because that's where it hits worse. That's where it really takes up a huge chunk of your hard drive if you want to use this thing, but it's going to impact the entirety of the next generation. So if you are a platform holder, if you're PlayStation, if you're Microsoft and their Xbox, you really need to be on the phone with companies like Activision saying, yeah, we understand you want to get all these things in, you want to make your textures glorious, but we have to figure out a way to not make this happen. We can't have Modern Warfare occur again. We can't have it be 250 gigabytes because the Series S can't support it. Probably can't support it with anything more than Hulu and Netflix on there if you really want to get serious and we want to sell these products. And we know you, Activision, want to sell your software product. So help us out. Because at the end of the day, and this is really why I wanted to make this video in the first place, and I don't know that people necessarily think about it this way, but these video game companies, these developers, these publishers, they want engagement, right? We see that all the time. This is how Lootbox came to be so prominent in the Electronic Arts business model before they weren't, before people rejected them wholeheartedly. It's why free-to-play is and operates how it does in terms of getting engagement, making sure you have live services to come in and continue to engage with. If you are Activision, and I'm coming at this from a business perspective, you want that engagement because ultimately you're going to be selling loot crates of some kind or ammo packs or cosmetics. You want that engagement. You want people playing Warzone and Black Ops and Cold War and whatever comes next. And what we are seeing now is, yeah, $70 is a lot of money for a video game, but people are used to buying Call of Duty and maybe they can eat that. That's fine. But it's not just a cost in money, but a cost in the one resource that you really can't necessarily control until you can expand these hard drives. And Microsoft has said that you can spend $200 and get an expansion of their hard drive. And Sony, I don't think, has revealed quite as much information about what they are going to accept as expandable hard drives. But you can do that for more money. But until you do, your main resource is hard drive space. And if you want to have Call of Duty on there at the same time that you want to have Assassin's Creed Valhalla on there or the next Rockstar game, whether that's a Grand Theft Auto or another Red Dead Redemption or whatever it might be, you're going to start to run into trouble. And if you're trying to move into a digital environment, which is more profitable for the Microsofts and the Sonys of the world, you don't want these big sizes preventing people from doing that. Now, in my opinion, maybe these sizes for the solid state drives are too small. And maybe it'll turn out that the actual advantages that you get, the load times, the bandwidth, whatever it might be, are so limited that they probably should have gone with higher end storage solutions. This was the cost of being able to deliver a product at $500 or at $300 or at $400, depending on which product we're talking about in these next generation launches. But if I can impress upon you one thing going away and exiting this video is that this is something that my old economics professor taught me, is that there's no such thing as a free lunch, which you might have heard before. But it doesn't mean that you're always going to have to pay in dollars for something. There's no such thing as a free lunch means there's no such thing as just having something and not having costs that are associated with it. And if you're Activision, or if you're a game player, or if you're Microsoft, or if you're Sony, you really have to start to be concerned about stories that come out like this that say, we're going to use this massive chunk of your hard drive. Because I can tell you from my gut reaction was, I don't even necessarily want to interact with this product because I don't want to have to spin plates and move things around, which obviously comes to the fore if you're on something like the PlayStation 5 Digital and you have to move these downloads around. You combine that with some kind of data cap wherever you might be living, and you start to have real problems with your product pipeline on the Sony side. You start to have real problems with engagement on the Activision side. You start to just have real problems with video games in general if these types of things can't be sorted. So I wanted to bring that to your attention. I thought it was a very interesting story, a combination of stories, really, with the size of the Series S kind of getting leaked and the size of Call of Duty coming out, which is one of those that I was tracking because Modern Warfare was such a problem for keeping on a system. And this isn't the only game that is like that. I have deleted games for being too big or for having updates that were too frequent and 50 gigabytes big. That's another issue that's kind of associated with this. If you've had similar experiences, if it's giving you any kind of pause in terms of interacting or buying into the next generation ecosystem, let me know. Let me know in the comments of this video. I'm really interested in seeing how people react to these kinds of questions because we are interested in the business, not just the law of video games and pop culture. And this is a business question and one where you've got a conflagration of different parties with different incentives Call of Duty, Activision wants to get the best product out there, but they also don't want to kill that engagement baby in its crib. So we will see how it goes. I'm excited about that game, of course. Disclaimer, my brother helped make it, so I'm excited about playing it and finally seeing what he's been working on for a while. And I hope you are too. And if you have any further comments, please leave them here in Virtual Legality. This has been Virtual Legality for today. If you enjoyed this video, please like, subscribe, share. We do talk about serious stuff. As I said, I think I referenced the Pennsylvania problem video, which is getting some hits and getting some comments on various aspects of social media, talking about a potential litigation scenario, which is becoming more prominent and possible as the hours go on from the election here in the United States yesterday. But we also cover things like pop culture, business and law of video games, and the other things that you are otherwise interested in. If you caught this on YouTube, thank you so much for watching. And if you listen to it as a podcast, thank you so much for listening. And I will catch you on the very next episode of Virtual Legality. Virtual Legality is a YouTube video series with audio podcast versions presented as commentary and for education and entertainment purposes only. It does not constitute legal advice and does not create an attorney-client relationship. If you have legal questions about the topics discussed, please consult your own legal counsel.